the maybe the activity of the community, how many alumni are donating as a proportion of everyone. So that's what the challenge that we set out to do. I'll show you how that actually happened, but the answer, the short answer is that we managed to triple the number of alumni giving in just 6 weeks. So that was, wow, that was great. Everyone was excited. There were people saying, well, this is just a one-year phenomenon. You cannot possibly repeat that the second year. But we also proved that wrong and managed to have a good growth also the second year. And we set out to beat Stanford in 3 years. This is 2 years, and we already had beaten them.
The Stockholm School of Economics is a world-leading business school in Riga. In 2011, only 11% of alumni donated to the school, while three times more was needed to grant scholarships for potential students in need. By no means SSE could dream of such alumni generosity, as the most successful schools in Europe do not have donation rates higher than 14%. Against all odds, we set our ambitions higher, aiming to beat Stanford, also known as the best fundraiser worldwide. We couldn't go with force, so we turned to wisdom. The bitter truth is that there will always be more people who want to have fun than people who care about the cause. First, we grabbed everyone's attention by publishing old pictures from the 1990s, revoking sentiments and putting warm memories behind the goal. Next, we turned fundraising into a social game, making a donation platform like no university had seen before. Enriched with game elements, live infographics, and integrated with social media, it exploded in the community in a matter of hours and became the most engaging SSE Riga campaign in just 3 days. When you make a donation, your class stands out in the infographics. By giving, you expand your home country's borders on the map. Your contribution builds your company's headquarters higher. As the most generous, you compete for the top place in the rankings. Challenging Stanford, we had to beat everyone on our way. Hardy Rock mascot was set alive as a face for our fight to be the world's most generous. First, Hardy led our alumni to hit the University of Dublin. Next, Hardy led us to beat New York. Then Berkeley. Next, Rochester. The alumni spirits were up. A week before the campaign end, we opened the last chapter of the game. The most generous could claim an auditorium chair online, getting their name engraved in real life. Finally, Hardy hosted his own party at the school, allowing to play the game more live than ever. Being a low-budget campaign aimed at a small community of 1,500 people from the three Baltic states, we managed to bring in an average of €1,500 per day. With one in three alumni donating, we raised an all-time record of €220,000, granting more than 60 scholarships for the future leaders. We aim to beat Stanford in 3 years' time. 2 years have passed, and Stanford is down. But most importantly, we sold 119 seats in the auditorium, and one is still free.